Welcome to another episode of Mile Point Through Garage. I'm Mandy.
I'm Chris.
And we got another email. This email was about the new Raptor, the Bronco Raptor coming out in 2022.
Yeah, so a year earlier than what I guess was originally projected. And then in the email was a video of the new Bronco Raptor. And it, so I thought maybe it was going to be, it was a YouTube video, so you click on the video, it plays, and it shows YouTube. Went to YouTube to try to find it. It's not on YouTube. So we assume that it was just sent to people on Ford's email list. And there may be some other ways to get that video. But we're going to link that down in the description so that you can watch the 10-second video that tells you not a whole lot. Yeah, it doesn't tell you a whole lot. But we did take a little bit from it, and then we're going to extrapolate on that just a little bit.
So we're pretty excited about the new Raptor coming out. We do have a 2013 Raptor truck that we absolutely love.
And so having, in one of our previous videos, we even mentioned that if a Raptor Bronco comes out, that's the Bronco that we want. First, the most noticeable thing in this video is the fact that the fenders are wider.
Like, it has shoulders.
Yeah, it has, that's a really good way to put it. It has shoulders on it. So when you look at it from the side, similar to the Raptor, the actual fenders stick out from the grill so that they're noticeably wider than on a typical 2021 Bronco. If you look at the fenders on a 21 Bronco, the actual fender comes down into a flat area that's probably about an inch or 2 inches wide before it goes to the fender flare. In the Raptor, that's eliminated. So you can tell that the fender flare is significantly higher up on the actual fender than the standard Bronco is. If you notice on the video, we actually slowed it down significantly and cropped this photo where it shows the fenders on this thing being super wide. And they look much wider than, for instance, the first edition or Wild Track fenders. So the new Bronco Raptor does have the three LED markers in the grill, similar to the standard Raptor, which is kind of I call it a hallmark of the Raptor. Signifying it as being a wider vehicle.
Like 80 inches wide.
Yeah, like at least 80 inches wide, correct. So vehicles 80 inches wide or wider have to have those identifying markers on them to show that it's a much wider vehicle. The 2021 Bronco Wildtrek is 79.3 inches wide. So it doesn't have to be a lot wider to get to 80 inches. So they could do that really easily with the shoulders that are built into it and the fender flares that are on it. That should easily get it to 80 inches. And I wouldn't be surprised if it was slightly over 80 inches wide. Because if you make it too wide, it doesn't make a very good trail vehicle. So I can't imagine that they would go super, super wide on this truck. Another piece that is easily identifiable in this is that it had an amber running light on it. Basically where the halo is for the headlight and the bar that goes across the front. His running lights are amber, which is kind of throwback to the Raptor as well.
Do you think it'll be an aftermarket product?
I think it would be. I think, you know, easily would be an aftermarket product. I think somebody is going to offer this halo for instance, our first edition if we wanted to have it like that. And then next would be what the Raptor is all about. Obviously, the Raptor is a desert runner. So the biggest changes are going to be, let's say, engine, suspension, things like that. And when you're talking about the engine, they're not going to keep the 2.7 in it. Obviously, it's going to have to be a bigger motor. And right now, almost everybody's saying that it's going to be the 3.0 EcoBoost that's going to be in Explorer ST, which is about 400 horsepower, 415 pounds of torque, I believe. Whereas our first edition is going to be 330 horsepower, 400 pounds of torque. A lot more horsepower, not as much of a gain in torque. So having the same engine as the Explorer ST kind of sounds a little bit weird. And so because of that, I think it's going to have maybe even a bigger tune than the Explorer ST. So maybe 425 horsepower, 450 torque, something like that.
What about the 3.5 EcoBoost that's in the Raptor?
So a full-size truck engine is going to be, I want to say that the 3.5 is going to be a much wider engine. So I actually have read that, and it looks like the engine is too wide for the current frame and the current body. So they would have to go through some pretty significant changes with the frame and the body in order to do that. Looking at everything else that's going on with Bronco right now, I don't know that they're going to design a brand new frame and body for, or at least a frame and engine bay to get a 3.5 in there. But we could be wrong. I know everybody that wants a Bronco Raptor wants a 3.5, and honestly, if the 3.5 were available in it, I would actually think about trading in my first edition for that 3.5 motor. But I don't think it's going to happen. And the 2.7 that's coming in our first edition is not a slouch. I mean, 330 horsepower, 400 torque. And then you can actually get a tune for it, which is available right now. That'll get it more like 365 horsepower, maybe even a little bit more than that, and like 460 foot-pounds of torque. And that's just what's available now that we've seen. But then you have bolt-ons as well that would get you even bigger gains. I mean, if you added cold air intake to it, that would probably get you quite a bit of horsepower as well. If you added an intercooler to it, if you added downpipes to it, that would probably work as well.
Higher octane fuel, a full exhaust.
Yeah, if you were to like modify the exhaust, if you were to change the exhaust out and eliminate the front cats and just had the rear cats and did a cat back, that would do a lot for horsepower, but it'd also be really expensive. So, but you know, you add all that into it and you're talking about probably getting close to 500 horsepower or more out of the 2.7. So I don't know that the 3.0 is a much better motor, but it is a better motor. Okay. So suspension is probably gonna be very similar to the regular Raptor now. So obviously it will have like the Fox Life Shocks on it because those are easy, those are already available. It'll probably have different springs in the back, maybe even softer, longer travel springs in the back. It'll have longer control arms or different control arms than the regular Bronco has, or at least that's what I think it will happen, because you need to have it have a little bit longer travel in it. So I think the longer arms would probably be something. And it also might have beefier tubes, similar to the Raptor, that would give it the ability to handle jumping and, you know, big impacts and things like that. So it may be actually uber built like that. It may not also. It may just be throwing some Raptor parts on it. Leaving the stock componentry for the most part. I think they'll beef it up a little bit though. I think in order to kind of keep it out of the stratosphere in price, because you're adding a bunch of stuff to this, I still believe that the Raptor will come in under the price of our first edition, which is about $63,000. I think it'll come in that $55,000 to $63,000 range. And by doing that, they're going to take some of the electronics out. So for instance, you know, we have all of the electronic driving aids and, you know, the 12-inch screen and stuff like that. I'm not sure what they're going to do with that, but they may drop some of that.
Do you think it'll have a sway bar disconnect?
That's a good question. So sway bar disconnect is, that would be something that I would still want to have, though. I think that's one of the coolest. When we did the Bronco Super Celebration, we drove in that Bronco. Probably the coolest thing about it was that electronic sway bar disconnect. So I would want to have it now in the Raptor. The actual Raptor, I don't believe has a sway bar disconnect. So I don't know if this Bronco will, but it might be an option. You might be able to option it out. But for a desert runner, you don't necessarily need that if the suspension is built correctly.
Right, but if you did have it, then you would use it for everything. Crawling.
Yeah, you could use it for crawling.
Except for what we do in Colorado.
I think that would be awesome. Other than the fact that it's a wider vehicle, it would be awesome for that. So tell us what you think about the new Bronco Raptor. We don't know if everything that we're saying is accurate. Obviously, this is a lot of conjecture. It's based on what we saw in the video, what we read in forums, what we know by owning a Raptor. So we're kind of pooling those three things together, and obviously they're teasing so that people will start to talk about it. So talk about it down in the comments. Tell us what you think it will and won't have. And also, I'd like to see if you guys can maybe take a stab at the price. This is going to be like Price is Right. We're going to see if we can get that. see if anybody can get really close. And then, are we going to change our first edition to a Raptor? After all of this time, if they had come out with this video back in June or July, maybe even early August, we might have waited for a 2022 to get a Raptor. But since we already own a Raptor, own a Raptor. At this point, for desert running and going fast, off-road and stuff like that, we already have a vehicle for that. And it hauls our motorcycle, so that's best. So I don't know that the Raptor version of the Bronco is for us. I think our first edition probably would work better. We're gonna put a lift on it and crawl it a little bit more. So I think that's probably where we're going to stay.
That's a wrap for Mile.3 Garage. Please like and subscribe.
Subscribe
and
right over
share
there.
Share this video.
We're gonna be getting our Bronco hopefully in October, and the first thing we're gonna do is go out and start wheeling it before the snow hits, and see if we can get some trips in. We'll see you soon.